Hi, my name is Yonatan Savir, and I'm an assistant professor at the Technion in Israel. I'm at the Faculty of Physiology, Biophysics, and Systems Biology. And our main interest is to study how living systems, cells, organisms, etc., respond to many, many signals at the same time. So one of the hallmarks of living systems that they have to cope not only with one signal or two signals, but with many cues at a very noisy milieu at the same time. So we try to use both experimental tools and theoretical tools to understand how this very, very complicated task is carried out. In today's talk, we talked about two examples for such an interaction of living organism with multiple signals. In one of them, we talked about how immune cells like T cells can interact in an environment where you have a signal that tells them to be anti-inflammatory and signals that tell them to be pro-inflammatory. What will a cell do? Will he become will he cause infection or not? The other example that we talked about was concerning to yeast, the humble baker's yeast, and the way it sense its environment and distinguish between many, many, many carbon sources, many types of foods in that environment. So some of the foods are very, very beneficial and very efficient. These are the chocolate of yeast, which is glucose, for example. But there's also other types of carbon source, like broccoli, which are less efficient to the yeast. And the question is, again, what happens when these cells is in the presence of both of them at the same time? What will it do? Will it eat the chocolate and then the broccoli? Will it eat both of them together? And what we showed, that the yeast have a very, very sophisticated switching strategy to cope with such situations. All this type of work will help us to understand not only a very basic mechanism that is in the root of many, many biological interactions, but also how to harness this knowledge to make immune cells and other cells respond better when facing disease and other conditions.